good morning. Let us begin to prepare our hearts for worship. We'd ask that if you are already seated, and if you are talking, that you would bring it to a cease. And ask that you're coming in, that you would begin to come in quietly. If you are talking, would ask that you would stop at this time. Let us take on a spirit of reverence as we begin to open up our worship service for this morning. Would ask that if you are still coming in, that you would come in quietly. Thank you. If you are whispering, let me ask that you would cease at this time. We are so happy to see all of you back and want to welcome you back for this week's chapel service. As you see printed in your bulletin, we wanted to place a little encouragement to you as we begin to embark at the end of this semester. We want you to always remember that it's not how you start, but it's how you finish. Amen? And as you've all come back, we want to encourage you to finish strong. Amen? As we've come back and we're preparing for the close of this semester, we have some young ladies that we want to recognize who are sharing with us, and we're so elated to have them with us this morning, the ladies of Jackson Central Mary, the Young Ladies Association. Would you stand at this time? Would you help me welcome them to Lane College? Amen. Thank you so much for coming to share with us. We're so grateful to have you today. At this time, we're going to have our call to worship by Ms. Jalen Smith, our prayer by Ms. Kamora Kimbra, our scripture by Ms. Naraya Johnson, our testimony by Ms. Kiana Shaw, and the ministry of dance by Ms. Oisha O'Neill. Following them, we'll have our announcements and special presentations. A musical selection, then Dr. Logan Hampton, president of Lane College, will come back to share with us today what the Lord has given to him. Let me encourage you as these people come, because I still hear a lot of you talking. Let me encourage you to be respectful of this time, not only of the time that we have to share and worship, but in those who are coming, to give them your undivided attention. Amen? Amen. Would you come?
Joyful shout to the Lord. Know that the Lord is God. It is He who has made us, and not we ourselves. We are God's people and the sheep of His pasture. Be thankful to Him and bless His name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and His truth endures to all generations.
Bow your heads, please. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You for this day that You have given us, for we know that all great things we receive come from You, Lord God. We thank You for Your grace and Your mercy, God, and we ask of Your blessing and Your active presence among us today. Lord, I ask that You touch each speaker and help them to flow with Your Spirit, Lord. Not ahead, not behind, but right on time, Lord. May Your Spirit move in our midst today, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
We speak the wisdom of God in a mystery, the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the ages of our glory.
which none of the rulers of this age knew, for they have known they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it was written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the hearts of men the things which God has prepared for those who love him.
Hello, my name is Kiana Shaw. I'm a 21-year-old junior. Today I came to read to you guys a poem that I wrote called Shadow Riders. Being here since my freshman year, I've noticed that domestic assault and sexual abuse are two real things that too many of both men and women know either too little or too much about. Situations don't discriminate. And honestly, if I wasn't introduced to the Lord Jesus Christ at an early age, I don't think I would be here. I'm not gonna give you a long introduction. I'm just gonna get into it because it's basically self-explanatory. Shadow Riders. I write in the comfort of a secure idea. Now secure, that is my place to begin. The days I began to write as a poet, I got tired of hearing folks complain about being a victim. He cursed at me. She shoved me. These are just some reasons offenders give to say that it was deserving. Remembering that he spat upon me and after leveling me to the mop guards and told me, you need to straighten up if you're headed to where I'm going. But where would I be now? I'm content with what took place, so is it really necessary to talk about it? Like the time he grabbed me by the back of my head and repeatedly beat my head against a steel locker. Then took me to the girl's restroom and said, clean yourself up. You better do something before the next time that I see you. He told me that he loved me every day. He took the time to show me on a good day. Good days became special days, and special days became scarce. How is someone able to tell you that they love you and hurt you before and after? Some say, that can never happen to me. The funny thing is that I once thought that very same thing. And now PTSD and depression for soon to be 10 years have all tried to consume me. It's to a point where now I forgot what my life was like before this. But you do not get that power. Some people don't like me, but a lot of those same people don't know me. They've never heard me talk about something this serious. She's weird. Yeah, well, that was before this. She's mad. I give you the reflection that you give off. She's angry a lot, not at anybody but myself, because I let people hurt me. A counselor once told me, people will only do to you what you allow them to. But what I don't get is how that can be said, but when a victim says, what did I do for this to happen to me? You're gonna sit there and you're gonna tell them nothing. The fault does not belong to you. People need to see what I did, and then you can judge. Like the time I asked him to meet me in the stairs before lunch so we could walk together. I saw him, and I hugged him. Walking down the stairs, I told him what a friend of mine told me, girl, you eat what you usually eat, but differently. And are you gaining weight? He didn't think that that was funny. He called me a whore. And by this time, I thought that, I guess he had forgotten that he was the only one to ever. But that wasn't by my choice either. So he pushed me down the steps and I fell. I fell down the stairs. Crawling for leverage, he kicked me again down the second flight. This day I received the worst beating of my life, but I felt stronger on the inside. I can name my ever-present dysfunctions, but my biggest regret is I gave your name and your title too much value, and it almost cost me my life. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Shaw, for the testimony, and thank you, Ms. O'Neill, for that ministry through dance. Thank you. Okay, prior to Thanksgiving, I told you I had some good news for you. We were down to 2 weeks in the semester. The news just keeps getting better. Now you're down to 1 week in the fall semester. So I need you to remember some of my F's. My F's are good F's, okay? The first F is obviously final examinations are coming up. That's next week. So you should be preparing for finals so that you can, the next F, finish strong. Okay, I don't want you to have to repeat any classes. My next F is related to registration for classes. Fast, fast, fast. I told you that registering was fast. It takes 5 minutes, okay? I have another F. This is an important F, especially for my seniors and my juniors. The classes are filling up. The classes are filling up, okay? I just spoke with Ms. Lumpkin on my way over to the gymnasium. I wanted to know if she had registered for classes and what her experiences were like. I was disappointed though, Ms. Lumpkin. She told me she started, but she did not finish. I need you to finish the process. If you encounter any problems registering, please see one of the faculty members, your academic advisor, or send me an email, mstewart@lanecollege.edu. M for Michelle, stewart@lanecollege.edu. We need you to register. My last F is one that I know many of you will appreciate during this time of the year, because it's the time of the year where you are buying people gifts. This is related to money, it's your finances. So it's the funds, the money, the finances. If you have $100, just bring it to me right now. $100, just run up here and give it to me. $100. You don't, okay. The reason why I'm asking you for $100 is because I've been checking those registration numbers and only about 50% of students have registered. If you do not complete the registration process by December 4th at 5 o'clock p.m., you're just gonna have to give us $100. The late fee is $100. No one came up here to give it to me, so I know no one wants to give me $100, okay? Or give the college $100. December 4th is the deadline for early registration. If you do not know how to register, please see me or see one of the faculty members about registering. Good luck with your final examinations, okay? Thank you.
Good morning. I was waiting on our ROTC people, but they had something to happen this morning to cause them to be running late. So I have good news for some of our students today. So again, good morning. Please join us and direct your attention to the center of the stage floor as we recognize and award ROTC students scholarships for our Lane College and Skyhawk Battalion cadets. Making the presentation is Dr. Logan Hampton and myself, Tiffany Young Pope. Okay. ROTC scholarships are distributed to cover tuition and fees or room and board and awarded to cadets based on them meeting high standards in particular categories such as GPA, the Army Physical Fitness Test, and leadership abilities assessed by the instructors and the director of ROTC program, Lieutenant Connell Howard. Okay. Here's our ROTC people now. And now that they're here, I'm gonna let Mr. Pillow do the announcements of our cadets.
Good morning. Thank you. said, okay. The first scholarship is for Cadet Shanice Catherine. Shanice is a junior biology major. This is a 2-year scholarship for room and board and for a book stipend in the amount of $22,400. The next scholarship winner is for Cadet Aurel Drummond. Aurel Drummond, okay. Cadet Drummond is a junior. He's a physical education major, and he also has a 2-year scholarship for room and board and a book stipend, and the amount is for $22,400. The next scholarship winner is for Cadet Anton Swanson. Cadet Swanson is also a junior, and he is a computer science major. 2-year scholarship for room and board, book stipend, and the award scholarship is for $22,400. These cadets just did the program last semester, and they went to the summer training, and it caught them up with the ROTC curriculum. And of course, they all did the hard work to qualify for this. The biggest thing being the GPA and being assessed as a cadet in the ROTC courses and the physical fitness test. Let's give them another round of applause. Thank you, Tiffany.
Praise him. Put your hands together and praise the Lord. And the church said amen. Church said amen. Amen. I want to say just a word as we prepare for finals, and we're in our final formal chapel of this semester. Over the last couple of weeks, as I've thought about this day, the Lord brought these words back to my heart as I was listening just a few weeks ago to our own bishop, Bishop Henry Williamson, preach. And these words just spoke freshly to my spirit, and I speak them to you. Our subject today is the best is yet to come. Would y'all say that with me? The best is yet to come. Wait a minute, I want to hear y'all say that. Say that back to me. The best is yet to come. Yes. In the Christian community, we have entered the season of Advent. This is the season in which we prepare to celebrate Christmas, the birth of Jesus. But we also prepare to celebrate Christ's return, when Christ shall return to redeem the world. And as we celebrate with hope and with love, with joy and peace. And we have great hope for a brighter and a better future. Every one of you assemble here today made your way to Lane College some time ago looking for a better and a brighter future. The Apostle Paul has a word for us today from 1 Corinthians, the 2nd chapter, the 9th verse. And the word reads, "But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered the heart of man, the things which God has prepared for those who love him." In this season of hope, we celebrate the best is yet to come. When we look about in this season, we see the Christmas lights. And the Christmas lights remind us that Jesus, the light of the world, was born. We're reminded in the Christmas lights that Jesus brought light into a dark world. Jesus came to light our way to a brighter and a better future. So my brothers and sisters, when you look at the Christmas lights during this season, I want you to have in mind that eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor has entered into the heart of man the blessings that God has set aside especially for you. As we look at our times and look at our days, there are some difficult times and days. We look around the world and ISIS is attacking. Folks are being shot on college campuses. Robberies are happening. Things can look bad. And I dare say we've had some difficult days in 2015. But we celebrate on this day because the light of Christmas reminds us that the best is yet to come. Some of you this semester have struggled in your classes, and some of you have even made some A's. But I want to even tell the ones that made some A's, know this, the best is yet to come. We've won some victories, and we've lost some battles. Don't worry about your losses. Don't even worry about your victories. Learn from them. And understand that what God has for you, you have yet to imagine how God is going to bless you. I look around this arena and I've got Jesus joy, and I'm shouting this morning. As I look over here and I see Dr. McCarthy, amen. Dr. McCarthy was in a math class and took ill, and some of his students were concerned and worried about him. And you all talked to me about him, and you prayed about him. But look at Brother McCarthy, who reminds us that the best is yet to come. Y'all ought to put your hands together and praise the Lord. We've had some struggles. We've had some struggles in sports. We've had some struggles on campus. But I ain't mad about it. I trust my God. I trust the word of God. I believe eye has not seen and ear has not heard. So let me say something to my men and women's basketball team. Yeah, you all had a little struggle. Praise the Lord. Amen. I mean, shucks, you can't celebrate if you don't have some struggle. Amen. But I stopped by on my way to heaven to let you know the best is yet to come. Y'all stay in the fight. Keep your head in the game. I've had some conversation with some of y'all. Some of you all have had a great roommate this semester. Some of you all have had some roommates that have lost their ever-loving minds. Oh, but don't worry about it, because the best is yet to come. Let me talk about the cafeteria. Amen. Praise the Lord. Woo! Woo, my Lord. Shucks, man. Talking about some struggles. Talk about some bad time. Talk about some hard time. I mean, there was one time, y'all texted me some pictures. I couldn't even figure out what it was. I don't have any idea. I don't know what's going on, amen. But I believe my Bible. I believe the Lord. And I believe this administrative team and this team that we put together to look at that thing is going to turn that thing around. I know that the best is yet to come. Y'all hold on. God has a new plan. Eye has not seen nor ear heard what God has in store for us. I want you to understand something as we talk about this, that God has a blessing that is beyond your imagination. Oh, there was Dewan Mallory last night. He's spoken into my spirit. I gotta tell you again, don't give up on God, because God will not give up on you. God has a better plan for you. God has a brighter future for you. You just hold on and watch God bless you beyond what you prayed for God to do for you. Watch God bless you beyond what you imagined God could do for you. What God has for you, no man has even imagined it right today, how God is going to bless you. So stay on God's pathway. Don't give up. Don't give in. Don't quit. Don't let go. Hold on. God has a blessing for you. Don't get off Faith Street. Oh, Steve Harvey. Y'all know Steve Harvey. I was watching Steve Harvey the other day, and he said these words. He told his people, he said, stay on Faith Street. He said, God is blessing folks who are on Faith Street. He said, some of y'all get off Faith Street. Y'all try to handle your own business. You try to do it your way. You try to steal, kill, and rob. You try to go out and take it. He said, no. Get back on Faith Street. Because on Faith Street is where God is handing out all of the blessing. I'll tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, get back on Faith Street. Get back on Faith Street. Listen, y'all know when the Lord started speaking to me about this thing, and the Lord said, there's some places some of y'all are being, y'all need to stay out from. Amen. Stay off Blunt Way. Come on with me now, amen. Get back on Faith Street. Y'all pray with a brother now, amen. Somebody put this in my spirit the other day. Don't turn on Hype Highway. Get back on Faith Street. Come on with me now, amen. Get back on Faith Street. Ain't no blessings in the trap. Come on with me now, amen. Amen. The trap queen, trap king, he ain't gonna do you right, amen. Get back
on Faith Street, stay on Faith Highway, because it's there on Faith Highway where eye has not seen nor ear heard what God has for you. While you're running around trying to get a blessing, God has a blessing for you on Faith Street. Glory to God. I'm about to run up out of here. Thank you, Oisha, amen. Did y'all shout on Oisha's dancing, amen? Praise the Lord, amen. She's been trying to praise dance for about 2 years now in chapel. Listen, we've been holding you back, blocking your blessing and blocking our blessing. How many of y'all were blessed by Oisha's dance today? Put your hands together. Brothers and sisters, here it is. Don't try to take the blessing. Wait on the blessing. How many of y'all remember when you were a kid, you used to try to rush Christmas? I mean, you want to rush Christmas. You made your Christmas list. You tried to do right. You did everything your parents told you. You were trying to rush Christmas. But how many of you were ever in your life ever able to speed up Christmas? Christmas is coming on December 25th. Regardless of what you do, it's going to be here. So you just get ready. You just get prepared. Listen, you can't rush the blessing of the Lord. You just got to wait on it. I think I got two people over here to understand what I'm trying to say right here. Amen. You can't rush the blessing of the Lord. You just have to wait on it. Let me see if I can get somebody over here to understand. You cannot rush the blessing of the Lord. You just have to wait on God to bless you in God's time. You just stay right where you are. Stay in faith and know that God does not lie. God does not speak untruth. If God said that eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor have entered into your heart what I have planned for you, you just believe it and trust it and hold on and wait on God to show up and show out in your life. Praise the Lord, amen. I'm about to run up out of here today, amen. I'm about to run up out of here thinking about how God is going to bless you all, amen. 1,300 students running around here just blessed, amen. 1,300 students running around here with God just being good to you. 1,300 students, we can just turn loose on the world, just been blessed at Lane College, now going out to bless the world. I'm about to praise the Lord up in here, just thinking about what God is going to do in you, through you, and to you. Woo! Glory. Isn't our God good? I had no idea 2 years ago that I was going to find my way to Lane College. I had no idea that I'd be here in chapel. I was working at a school where you couldn't even talk about the Lord. You couldn't even talk about God. I used to tell my boss every now and then, I used to say to my boss, I said, I love my job here. I said, the only thing I don't like about my job is, or the only thing that could make my job better, if we could just stop on Wednesday and just have Bible study at noontime. This is what I was telling my boss at another job, at another place, years ago. I said, man, yeah, I really like it, but you know, I wish I could be in a place where I could just, you know, praise the Lord and I could just teach the Bible on Wednesdays at 11 o'clock. That would make the day and the week so much better. That's what I was telling them 2 years ago, 3 years ago, that I wanted a job in a place where we could just stop and just pause and praise the Lord on a Wednesday at 12 o'clock. Well, I got the time wrong, glory to God, amen. But that's how the Lord has blessed me. The Lord blessed me even before I was thinking about it, before I knew about Lane College. Come on with me now to bring me to this place that everything that I wanted could happen right here and I could pour into some folks and help them become better people. You can't tell me that eye has not seen, ear has not heard what God has for you if you'll just hold on. If you'll just hold on and wait for God to bless you the way God wants to bless you. Stop trying to take it. Stop trying to make it. Hold on and let God bless you like God wants to bless you. God keep you and bless you is my prayer. Let's pray. Let's pray. And I wanted y'all to pray, pray in this way. As Lord put this in my spirit, Lord put this into my spirit. And then he dropped a movie. How many of y'all have seen Boys in the Hood? If you've seen Boys in the Hood, raise your hand. A few of y'all have seen Boys in the Hood. All right. If you're sitting beside somebody from Boys in the Hood, tell them to ask you later, and you will explain it to them, all right? Okay. All right, let's go to the movie. Oh, y'all, wait a minute. Y'all, let me go pray. Now, I'm letting y'all, we're going to get out of chapel early if y'all stop talking. All right. So here it is. Here it is. At the end of the movie, at the end of Boys in the Hood, see, I remember, it was Ricky, wasn't it Ricky the football player? So Ricky gets shot. Ricky gets killed, right? And so Trey runs, he sneaks out of the house, gets in the car with Doughboy and two other guys, I don't remember their name. There was one of them, the one was sucking the pacifier. Y'all remember the scene? All right, so you got Doughboy and I don't know who the other fella, you got the fella loading the AK. All right, so you got the guy loading the AK. Doughboy is driving. Ricky didn't have him by now. Trey on the passenger backside, and then the fella with the pacifier. Y'all see the scene? They're riding for about 2 hours looking for the people who shot Ricky. Y'all remember that? The scene is quiet and it's dark. And then from nowhere, Trey says, "Let me out." Doe kind of looks over at him. Then Trey says, "Dope, let me out." Then Doe pulls over. He lets Trey out. Trey gets out, goes back to the house. Doe goes and they kill the guys. At the end of the movie, we learned that Doughboy got shot 2 weeks later. We learned that Trey went on to college down south. Some of you all are on the wrong highway, traveling with the wrong folks, and you need to speak a word. Let me out. I need to get to God's blessing. I need to get back to where God wants me to be. God is ready to bless me, but I can't be blessed if I'm traveling in this direction. You've got to pray, and you got to have courage. Let me out and get out. Do that thing and go to that place that God has for you. Some of you in some relationships, you got to pray, let me out. Some of you in some situations, you got to pray, let me out. Some of you got some habits, you got to pray, let me out. And you've got to be willing and courageous enough to get out and go get the blessings that God has for you. God bless y'all. God keep y'all. Merry Christmas. Bye.